that this present leadership was elected from the first to the second day of March 2017 at Burutu, and we were immediately inaugurated and sworn in, and the leadership handed over to us. Hands on, however, it is the tradition of the IYC that when a new leadership comes on board, there must be a traditional inauguration celebrations where the president of council will present his vision to the people, and that is usually done in the zone of the city president, and that is the reason why we are seated today. Hands on, the essence of today's celebration is for me to present to the young nation and to the Nigerian people the strategic direction of my leadership, what I intend to do as president of the Joint Youth Council, and what the 7th National Executive Council intend to do. The IYC was formed in 1998 to pursue two agendas: self-determination and resource control. The IYC under my leadership, the main focus of my leadership will be to actualize self-determination for the young people. Eyes on here. Self-determination may mean different things to different people, but to us as young people, self-determination means having a political space where we will have control of our resources and govern over ourselves. We do not want a situation as it is now, where the young people are organized in six different states as minorities except Bayelsa. In Ondo State, the young people are minorities.
Thank you.
Whereas we are the mainstay of that state. In Edo State, the young people are not just minorities, but they are treated like third class citizens. In Delta, especially in the Warri part where we are standing here, we are treated like second class citizens. We can vote, but we cannot be voted for. We can only produce a House of Assembly member, we cannot produce a council chairman without begging. For instance, in Warri South here, we cannot even produce a councillor. In Bayelsa, with even the abundant resources that we have, there is nothing to show for us. Similar problem exists in Akwa Ibom and River State. Therefore, what my leadership will be fighting for is a political structure that will bring all the young people together. I don't care what you call it, whether it is region, whether it is municipal council, whether it is local government, it doesn't matter. But what we want is that all the young people must be in the same political structure and have control over their resources. This is going to be the direction of my leadership.
Thank you.
We are not going to look for petty things like come and give us jobs, come and give us a no. Once we have a structure that is under our control and we control our resources, we can build 50 maritime universities. We don't need to go and beg the federal government to build maritime universities.
Oh yes.
That is the direction of my leadership. In the next few weeks, we are going to take key steps to engage with other ethnic nationalities in Nigeria. We will engage the Igbo people. We will engage the Middle Belt. We will engage the Hausa people. We will engage the Yoruba people on the terms of our engagement as a country. On what basis are we going to continue to live together as a country? But let me make this point very clear. Hands on, the young people are not part of the Biafra territory. We have a self-determination struggle that has been in existence even before the Biafra people came up. Some of you are aware that our leader, Major Jackson Adakaboro, declared the 12 days revolution even before Ajuku declared Biafra Republic.
Yes.
Therefore, the young people cannot be subjected to the Biafra Republic. So moving forward, my leaders, traditional rulers, my comrades, I beg you to join me in this revolution. What we're about to start here is a revolution. And let me also make this point, that the IYC is a grassroots pressure group. It's not a government organization. It's not an extension of any government. We will collaborate with government where necessary, but we will not be subjected to any government. We will not be subjected to any government both at the state and federal level, but we will collaborate with government where necessary. So I want to thank you for coming to witness my presentation of my strategic direction. I look forward to work with you. Very good for our eyes on.
Please put your hands together.
Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen. Now, Pastor Joanne, the Lord has spoken. The Lord has spoken with me again about the meeting of the Lord that's coming up in Lagos, Nigeria. And in that conversation with the Lord took me to the Conference of Pastors, the mighty Conference of Pastors that will be there, and also the healing service. This is now one of a series of conversations that the Lord is having with me regarding the Church of Christ in Nigeria. And I see in the Conference of Pastors, as his servant was ministering there, then the Lord showed me the pillar of his glory come on his servant. So there's going to be a big visitation in Nigeria, a very big visitation. Again, I saw in this first night the Lord speak with me about the huge Conference of Pastors that will take place in Lagos, Nigeria. And it looks like all the heavenly hosts are now focused. The emissaries of God are all focused on Nigeria and the meeting in Lagos. And he showed me in that meeting, I saw the Lord raised me above, and I saw with the eyes of the Lord. When I looked in, I saw the meeting of the Lord, and I saw that when his servant was there ministering, then a pillar of his glory came, and there was a huge situation. May the Lord be blessed that he has remembered the church at this hour. So there is a big, big visitation. The heavens will be open over Nigeria, and this is the moment to catch, the moment of revival, the long-awaited time of restoration. The Lord Jehovah has spoken with me about that tremendous visitation that will take place in Nigeria. And for all the peoples of the earth, it's also the time to hearken unto the voice of the Lord, that we may prepare a way of holiness, turning away from all manner of sin, choosing righteousness as the pillar and foundation of our lives, and preparing for the glorious coming of the Messiah. Shalom, shalom, Haverim. Shalom, Todah Rabbah.